Hi guys, fresh from eBay, this aircraft instrument made by Smiths in Great Britain. We have here an indicator of drift angle and ground speed made by Smiths, but under license of the Deca Navigator Company. Serial number is 3239. So here is what it looks like on the front panel. We have one needle indicator with indicating some drift degrees angle. Either P or S, I have no clue what it does. We have a warning flag at the top. Some other thing here in the hole, and here the counter for the ground speed knots. So I got it for 10 euros on eBay with domestic shipping, so I guess it is not too bad. Here is the rear plug. I did already remove the screws. So what do we have inside? Quite simple electronics, in fact. So I will open it at this level in order to show a little bit in here, but in fact I cannot remove a mechanical assembly from the front body because under this washers here there are some kind of weird circlips which seem very small and delicate, and I do not want to mess with them. So here we have basic electronics. You can see the wire loom is very well attached with these pieces of blue ribbon, typical in British-made avionics. There is one teardown, I believe, from Mike Electric staff of English-made control panel, and there is the same thing inside. And maybe from another channel to Sigma Technica also, there is one teardown where you can see this. Here you have three small holes, three small circles, rather. It means it is using ISO screws, I believe. And you can see for this wire loom here, there is either a bracket bolted in here to keep it in place. So what do we have on the PCB? We have capacitors, resistors, very basic stuff. You can see this capacitor is held in place with a piece of ribbon too. Here we have what seems to be a Torina transformer. Here we have something that looks like a backup battery, but it is probably not a backup battery. No clue what it is, maybe a temperature sensor. Some old school transistor here. And here we have a power transistor. It is written CV7085. Date code, guys, of 1966. So it is a pre-1970s stuff. And here you can see all the wires going to the front part with all the actuators here. So one thing to take this apart. You need a 5mm wrench, not 4.5, not 5.5, 5. And if you haven't got a good quality wrench, you cannot undo the nuts because they are self-locking nuts. They are very hard to turn and quite delicate. So I will remove these four nuts and we will have a look to the actuators. Okay, so now I can separate these two parts. So you can see how it looks like this kind of not a PCB, because in fact they are point-to-point boards, some kind of white fiberglass-ish material. Here one more terminal board, the cables with this pink heat shrink. And here are the actuators. I see three of them. This seems to be a regular, simple motor, not sure. Yes, not a lot of wires going to this one. On the two synchro resolve synchro motors, synchro repeaters, something like this. Not sure what the exact name for them is. So about this nuts here, which seem to allow to remove the wall inner mechanical assembly from the front part of the instrument. In fact, if I remove here, you will see we have some kind of little circlip in here, preventing to pull the piece. So it is quite weird. What can I see in the bottom here? I can see two mechanical frames with gears inside. So probably just mechanics. There must be a backlight too, I guess. This here we have two wires, black and red. There must be backlight. There must be backlight. Here you can see this kind of small washer, quite nice in fact, aluminium made. And here we have the standoffs, threaded standoffs to assemble this electronics module. So very well made, but sadly I will not be easily able to go take it apart further. So we will stop at this level. But it is really, really a beautiful piece. Look at this PC transformer here. It's really attached firmly to the board. And every part, nothing can move in this. It is quite amazing, in fact. Okay, so thanks for watching. Bye bye.